皆様、明けましておめでとうございます。今年もどうぞよろしくお願いします。ご紹介に預かりました、元文学青年のアトキンスです。こんばんは。ちょっと、まずは、読みますね。君がため、春の脳に入れて、若夏む。I wonder, does anybody know what comes next after that one? The answer is, 我が衣でに、雪は降りつつ、If you're playing the game at home, this is the card you would grab with the karta game. Be careful to grab this card. Don't grab this card. Maga koromo de wa tsuyu ni nuretsutsu. This is number one. You have to grab this card. That's the hyakunin issue game, the karta game. I think many of you who grew up in Japan or spent time in Japan have played it, especially around New Year's Day. People have been playing this game for at least, I think, about 300 years throughout the Edo period, really.And it's a really fun way, an elegant way to spend the New Year holidays, which were so recently upon us. But it's actually also a work of literature. It's a collection, as the title says, 100 poems by 100 poets, 100 waka poems in the 31 syllable form by 100 poets, beginning from Emperor Tenji of the Nara period down to retired Emperor Jintoku of the Kamakura period. That's a very long stretch.Of Japanese literary history. And it's also a little micro world. It's a virtual world. We're in our little virtual world right now. People play video games, people watch TV, we listen to the radio, we daydream, we think about the past, we worry about the future. We actually spend a lot of our waking lives, not really waking, but in virtual worlds. And poetry is a virtual world also. It's an alternate form of reality.This anthology, this little anthology, which is we treat as a game, was actually also used for centuries as an entree into the whole world of classical waka poetry, this virtual world. And the two main topics that we see in this anthology are love and nature. The poems, like any poems, give us a lens through which we can see the natural world and also the human world.And reflect on ourselves. I think by doing, I've been reading these poems for the last 30 years, and I think they're wonderful. By reading these poems, I think we see the world in a different light. We live slightly richer and deeper lives, and that I think is valuable to us. Lots of things going on in the world right now, lots of turmoil. We're in the middle of a pandemic. Hyakunin issue, I'll talk a lot about how it was created.During the Chusei period, medieval period in Japan. And let me tell you, these people had it a lot worse than we did. Epidemics were common, famine, drought, disease, warfare. Between 1467 and 1600, Japan was basically in a civil war the entire time. And for the first 10 years of it, Kyoto, the capital, was the battlefield. Kyoto was destroyed by a civil war that lasted 10 years.You might have heard of the Onin no Ran, or the Onin War, that happened during that time. And they took busy time when they weren't worrying about the problems. And people would spend time reading these poems and then later on memorizing them. If you memorize them, you have them with you everywhere, at all times, anytime you want. So I think this is a very special collection. I'm going to talk on my lecture on March 3rd a little bit about it.I have my abstract here for you. I have this flyer, a beautiful flyer with a graphic. I'll explain that when we get to it. And I want to invite you all to it. The JBAS is a sponsor, co-sponsor of this event. This is your event. I'd love to see many of you there. And I guarantee you will learn something.About classical Japanese literature. As if you've been to my previous lectures, which are on our website, washinkai.info, you know that I try to make things easy to understand, but I do try to go deep and make a deep dive. So please do join us if you can on March 3rd. It's the same day as Hinamatsuri, actually the same day I gave my last lecture before the pandemic last year on Zekkai Chushin. It'll be 7 p.m. online and it's free.So please come and bring friends. どうぞよろしくお願いいたします。